Hey guys, got a 300mm f4 Super Takumar here. I know some people in some groups have been asking on how to service one or how to get into the lens, not even necessarily the service. So, do a quick overview on it. It's a very good lens. I got this one at a very good price. I do not have the tripod collar for it. I had to 3D print one myself. It works. It's fine, but if you can see it, there is a nick on the glass here. My front ring is not pretty, but it doesn't really matter too much to me. It does a very good job. All six aperture blades work just fine on mine. I have no issues with it. Focus is fine. Alright, so this ring is damaged in the front because in order to get to this front element, you do have to remove it. If you have no reason to get into it, do not try to remove it. It could be pretty tough. In this video, I'm not going to mess with it. You extend it out to minimum focus. Grab onto the end here. Grab onto this front. Give it a good twist. There we go. This back half will spin off. There we go, that's that. Let's set this over here. You can remove the lens hood if you need to. This back half spins off itself, and then this slips right out. My lens hood is not in the best of shape. It has clearly been banged up a couple of times before I got it. Cleaning this back element is a little tricky. It is recessed in there pretty deep. As I mentioned, if you don't have to touch this front glass, I wouldn't try to mess with it. You will either end up tearing up the front name ring, or you will have to send this to somebody who has the appropriate special tool to fit. It's very tricky. There's two small notches on the inner ring to hook into it with a lens wrench to spin it off. If it's stuck on there, you're gonna have to be very patient. But like I said, if you don't have to mess with it, don't. You're gonna save yourself a lot of trouble. Put my lens hood back on. If you're trying to replace the felt material on the inside, this is when you would do it now, so that you have a lens hood that doesn't keep slipping off like mine does. This ring just spins right back on. Careful not to cross thread it. There we go. Okay, so that's that. Coming back to the actual lens body, there's still a glass element at the end. See the focus threads on the inside here. I would be careful not to get them dirty, but if you're servicing it, you're probably going to be cleaning them, lubricating them anyway. There's three small screws around the exterior of this lens to remove the focus ring. Let's see. This is the right one. Okay. Careful not to unscrew them all the way. You don't want to lose these. I want to say they're like a 2mm. Let me see if I remember if I'm doing this correctly. Set your focus, the grip. Put this over here. From here, I would mark where they line up. You can kind of see on this one, there's already a bit of a blemish there. Same thing on this side, it's been marked. It does have a stop anyway. I would definitely make a mark just so you know where you left off. Makes it easier when it comes to reassembly. It's going to be two small screws here that hold this little plate in place. The next ring will not be able to come off. This is the focus end stop, essentially. Be careful not to lose these two screws as well. Make that one fall out. There it goes. Get this one out. Okay. From here, this is the little bracket. Put that to the side. Let's see. There's going to be an even smaller screw to remove the next ring. Okay. Same thing with these. Do not remove them all the way. They're very easy to lose. And I want to see these are like a 1 millimeter screw, maybe less. Okay, so from here, you're gonna have three other screws along the side. Let me switch. These are slightly bigger, not as easy to lose. There's gonna be three of them all the way around. This focus coil should come right out. From here, you don't really need to do much with this other half. I'm gonna flip this one over. If you wanted to take these off to clean the numbers on them, you could. This ring here, your actual aperture ring, be careful with it. The ball that makes it click is kind of spring-loaded. You don't want to lose that. If you want to de-click it, go ahead and lose it. But I wouldn't. So that's that. You set this part to the side. Unless you have an issue. I have yet to see a Super Takumar that has an issue with his rear half that controls the aperture. But I'm sure somebody out there has a problem. This is it. Let's see. Okay, so from here, this silver pin that sticks out controls the actual aperture blades inside. This rear cone here, you should be able to just kind of grip and spin. It gets you up close to the rear glass element if you need to clean it. Removing this one, I'm not going to remove it, but in order to remove this one, you do need a lens wrench. I don't think you can get this back half off without it. It's going to be two small notches on the inside to remove the ring that holds it in place. If you don't have to mess with that, don't mess with it. Let's see. You can see I already have some marks here from a previous service for the focus. If you twist this all the way off, I would be careful to make sure that you know where it comes out. That's why you would mark them where the threads separate. You have two little brackets on this back half that actually hold the, if I care, I'm gonna mark this so I make sure. Okay. These two brackets stop the lens assembly from spinning as you adjust the focus. This one is a plastic bracket, at least on my lens. That comes out. This is a point of movement on the lens, so when you reassemble these, I would definitely re lubricate these little brackets. They kind of fit into a groove. Let's see. Come on. There we go. Okay. This back half will spin freely without those brackets in place, which is why you have to have the markings on there. Let's see. Okay, so kind of about a quarter turn there. So from fully tightened, I am off one turn back, which is important to know. You could count the turns off if you wanted to. It's easier, in my opinion, to go all the way in and then count how many turns off you are the other way. So with that being said, I'm going to remove this bracket or this barrel. There's a lot of threads on this. It is a very fine thread, so it does spin off a lot of turns. Just like that, that's off. You can see on the inside there those two notches where the little brackets would slide in. From here, you can spin this ring off very slowly. If you have a mark on the barrel somewhere, I'd make note of it so you can see where they separate. Trying to find the threads and getting them to catch the first time with no markings is a bit of a trial and error. Don't recommend trying to do that. It might take you a couple days. So I'm getting very close here. I have one mark up here. See if it can get to show right there. So I'm using that mark by my thumb, going very slowly to see where they're going to separate. And you can see I have another mark here. It's about to line up. It's off by just a notch. So from there, clean your threads, clean the threads on the inner barrel, clean these fine threads on this barrel. If you mark them, you shouldn't have as much trouble getting them to kind of line up. Come on. This is why you'd mark them, because otherwise you'd have no idea where you're starting off from, and you'd have to just spend all day slowly spinning until you could find where it's going to catch. I'm trying to see if I can get it to go in. You see just how much trouble it is to do it, even when you know where it's going to line up. There we go. So right there, caught again. Spin this back in. I don't have to service my threads. They are pretty okay. I am going to clean this back element before I reassemble it. If you need it to get into the aperture blades, let's see. Just in case somebody's watching this and wants to fix a sticky blade. There's gonna be three small screws on this inner portion here. Each of them does have a washer with it, so be careful not to lose them. This side might have already had the washer lost. No, it's there. I'm just like that. You can pull this inner cup out. The rear lens is still in there. You can set that to the side. From here, you can see the actual aperture blades, how they would work. These three screws you'd have to remove. If you don't have to mess with this, I don't recommend messing with it. This is more advanced than I would recommend for anybody who's never serviced a lens before. But that gets you pretty much through the entirety of the lens. I wouldn't really say there's much to this lens. I'd say it's a simple design. Six aperture blades. If, let's say, they're a little sticky, you could try and wipe them down from here, but I would recommend going entirely into it and replacing everything. But be very delicate. These blades are very thin. It's very easy to break one or to bend one, or there's little pins that will hold them in place around, and then a little pin that rotates them in and out. It's very easy to snap one off. So I'd be very delicate if you were going to service one, especially with this back pin. You don't want to snap this off. You're never going to find another one. Okay, so I kind of glossed over this rear lens element. I have removed this little tube portion, but this back half from this back cylinder here does come off. There's two notches on the sides of it. You will need a lens wrench. I wouldn't recommend trying to do anything without a lens wrench on this lens. But you have to hook into these two notches and then spin it loose. The design on this lens, I have the Pentax guide here. This is a 5 lens elements and 5 groups lens. The front half, this portion here, actually has 3 lens elements. And this back half, this has 2 lens elements in it. When I got this lens, I got it for a pretty good price. There was fungus in between these two, so I couldn't just clean it the way it was. I actually had to remove this small ring on the inside. Again, you will need a lens wrench to get it loose. I suppose you could try to go through this side too. Same thing, you're gonna need a lens wrench. I had to clean the fungus off in between these two lens elements. If you have no reason to do that, I wouldn't recommend trying to. If there's maybe a couple of dust specks, I would just live with it. There's no reason to try and mess with it. It's very easy to slip with a wrench and then nick the glass, or just straight up ruin what is a perfectly fine lens. But if for some reason, let's say you did have to service it, that's what you would have to do. You'd have to remove at least one of these elements from either side and then clean in between them. I have no reason to do that, so I'm not going to. Okay, so reassembly of this lens. Going to start off with, put a paper towel down if you can. As you can see, I'm leaving grease rings pretty much everywhere. It's fine, I do need to clean this desk mat. Going to start off with the aperture mechanism that I took apart. You're going to want to try and line this up as best you can in the back to make sure that the pin will move freely from either direction. There is an adjustment that can be done on this. I will show you when I get this together. I'm just going to skip past the screw installation. Okay, so you can... Let me get this focused. Where is it? What side's the best one? Okay. This side already has a screw in it. There's a vague marking right where the screws used to be. I don't know if you can see that there or not. Well, this side's probably a better one. There's a very vague marking in there from where the screw used to sit. I would definitely use that to line it up again. If it is off slightly, your lens might either be stopped down just a little bit when it's wide open, or you might not actually be able to reach the fully stopped position. This lens goes down to f22, and you might be just shy of it. It might not matter to you, but I definitely recommend to try and line that barrel up with the marks previously left. All right, so that's all back together. This rear half. Thankfully only starts, there's only one thread. If you remember, before I put this together, I counted the amount of turns off it needs. So I'm just gonna screw this in all the way. Until it's seated, and from there, so marking, it's one turn off. Did mark this inner portion as well, so as to where it needed to be lined up. From here, I can install these two brackets that hold it in place. I'm gonna skip installing that. I don't think you need to see this. Okay, so those two brackets are in. When this inner ring spins, you should be able to extend this barrel. As I mentioned, these two brackets essentially guide the actual optics in and out without rotating as you change your focus. So with that being said, I'm going to wipe down this back element because it is kind of hard to access once it's this little cover is installed, and then when it goes back into the aperture block. So I'm going to do that. Okay. So with this back half set to F4, this fork on the inside here has to line up with this pin. They have to fit into each other. That fork is what rotates that. So with the lens set at wide open, the back half set to F4, you can begin to try to line them up. You might have to try and look through the back to see the pin exactly. Okay, so I got that in there. If you want to try, you can hold it in place and then rotate the ring. If I can. Yeah. So let's see. There we go. That's fine. From here, this ring has to slide back up. These three screws that we removed earlier have to go back in. So I'm going to do that real quick. Okay, so with those three screws installed again, you can take this ring, slide it back over, and slide it down in place. Try to make sure it's not too tight. You do want to be able to move the aperture freely. That feels better. Get the orange marker lined up with the four. Seems right. And then from here, tighten the three small screws to go around it. You want to be careful with these screws. They are very small. You don't want to strip one. They're all snug. My ring still rotates pretty well. So, from here, you can bring the focus barrel back. This bracket does need to go in first. That's the little two screw holes by the aperture marker. Out. This is a little tricky to do because you do have to find a way to hold the bracket in place. So I'm just going to skip over it. Okay, so that bracket's back in. focus can go over the top of it. As I mentioned earlier, that is the focus end stop there. So there is a way to adjust the minimum focus on this. I'm going to tighten the focus barrel in place. This won't work. I'm actually going to tighten it off of infinity focus just a little bit, so that when I put the lens back on my camera body, I can adjust the infinity focus. Okay, for now that holds it. That's fine with me. So you can take your front lens group, just fit it back in place. Snug that in place. That's pretty much assembled. So from here, I'm going to slap it on one of my camera bodies, and then I'm going to set it up and focus on something far away. If I can reach infinity focus how it is, then I'm pretty good to go. Actually, I got this plate just off by a hair, so it doesn't actually line up with the infinity. I'll adjust that later. Set this up, focus on something far away, go past it just a little bit, and then set your infinity focus there. You don't want to set infinity focus at the hard stop. In the event you're using this outside with a temperature change, maybe it's colder or hotter, you do want to give this lens a little bit of room for expansion and contraction. I've had a couple of lenses, mainly my 200mm that I first serviced. I set it up, focused to infinity, there was no issue. I took it outside one night, it was colder, and then infinity focus was off by just a hair. And so then I had to go back into that lens, service it again, and then set the infinity end stop to be just a hair past infinity. So yeah, I'll be back when I service that. Okay, so this lens goes just a little too far past infinity for my liking. So I've set it to where I want it to be. From here, take the camera body off. Once you set it to where you want it to be very careful not to spin the focus. You don't want to have to do this more than once. So from here, I'm going to loosen these three screws again on each side. You want to make sure that they are sufficiently loose. Then you're just going to carefully rotate this ring, the focus ring, all the way till it hits the infinity end stop. I don't know if it's loose enough. Might be it. So from there, you can twist it, hits the infinity end stop. From there, you just tighten them. And from there, you have a lens that will go just past infinity. And on a cold night or on a hot summer day, you shouldn't have any issues reaching infinity focus. Maybe you're doing bird photography, or perhaps you're trying to do some astrophotography. You do want to have that freedom to hit infinity focus at any temperature with no issues. So that's pretty much it. That's a 300mm Super Takumar. As I mentioned, this lens is by no means in good shape. The front element does have a nick on it. It's my fault. The lens hood is loose on it. You know, the lens is very beat up. You can see some markings around the base of it. Whoever had it previously sold it without the tripod collar, so I had to 3D print one in order for me to use it with a tripod collar. Otherwise, I don't really have a choice. I would have to handhold this lens every single time, which can be done. You can definitely handhold this lens. I wouldn't say it's a very heavy lens. This thing's a little more in a tight fit. That's my 300mm f4 Super Takumar. It's not a super multi-coated, sadly. But it's enough for me. I got it for less than $100. I think it's pretty good. It does have a decent amount of chromatic aberration. So when you do use this lens, I do recommend stopping it down to at least f8. But you're going to have to probably go past that to f11 or f16. It's just kind of what you're going to have to do. I shouldn't have put this on yet. Doesn't really bother me, I guess. That orange marker is off, but just a bit. But I don't feel like taking this thing off again, so I'm just going to leave it where it is. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully this does help someone who either picked one up cheap, or maybe you got one as a gift from somebody, a hand-me-down, can't afford to have it serviced by somebody professionally, or maybe just want to mess with yours. I don't recommend playing with it just for fun. If you don't have to service it, do not try to service it. But at the end of the day, it is your lens. You can do whatever you want. If in the event maybe you're a professional lens servicer and you're doing this for a customer, hopefully this helps you get into it a little quicker. You can return this lens to them faster and they can go out with it as soon as possible. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys.